What was your reaction when you first read or heard that there is no cure for cancer or heart disease? Do you know someone who has had those diseases? How would that person react when you told them that there is no cure? Your answer highlights your current attitudes about medicine and disease. If you found yourself not believing the statement that there is no cure, then it means you are probably still enmeshed in the traditional lines of thinking. You are in good company, as millions of people are still looking for magic bullet to cure chronic lifestyle diseases. But are we not healthier than before? It is certainly true that we are healthier than before. 100 years ago, an average person used to live up to his 40s or maybe 50s. But today, an average person lives up to 70s, which is an increase of almost 30 years. The main reasons for this increased life expectancy are due to greater access to clean drinking water, flush toilets, better hygiene, and better public health education. Probably only 5% of our increased life expectancy has been the result of improved curative medicine. Yet, illogically, 95% of our healthcare resources are focused on curative medicine, which is on giving the patient the right drug rather than on disease prevention. We are finding now that the rates of heart disease, cancer, diabetes, osteoporosis, Alzheimer's, etc. are skyrocketing in all developing countries that have adopted the Western lifestyle. Let me now introduce you to the concepts of vertical and horizontal medicine. The barrier of medicine's tradition of organizing doctors into rigid specialties is to be looked into deeper. The cardiologist treats the heart. The neurologist treats the brain. The gastroenterologist treats the stomach. And the rheumatologist treats the joints. Too often, a doctor's knowledge is vertical rather than horizontal. Most of the doctors understand their specialty deep down into science, but many do not have much understanding across all other disciplines of medicine equally well. If you go to your gastroenterologist and say that your stomach hurts and that you also have a rash and that all your joint hurts, the doctor might well say that he shall take care of your stomach, but you must go and see a dermatologist for your rash and a rheumatologist for your joints. Unfortunately, this separate approach contradicts how the body works. A stomach problem can cause skin problems and joint problems. Unless you deal with all the problems together, you may not get to the root of that problem. What complicates the matter is that the field of medicine has given rise to a slew of organ-based specializations such as neurology, cardiology, dermatology, ophthalmology, urology, etc., and few of organ-based specializations like oncology for cancer and gerontology for the disease of aging, each of which has the respective modes of treatment and therapy. End result is a medical model, not unlike the legend from our own country about the six blind men who had encountered an elephant. There once were six blind men who, upon encountering an elephant, gave their own individual assessments of the elephant. The first one happened to fall against the broad and sturdy side of the elephant and concluded that the elephant is very much like a wall. The second one, feeling the tusk, said the elephant was very much like a spear. The third one happened to take the quivering trunks in his hands and said the elephant was very much like a snake. The fourth one reached out and touched the elephant's knee and concluded that the elephant is very much like a tree. The fifth one happened to touch the ear and insisted that the elephant is very much like a fan. And the sixth one seized the swinging tail and said, the elephant is very much like a rope. Each of the blind men was partly right based on his own subjective perception, but at the same time mostly wrong. The comical part of it all is that their dispute stemmed from utter ignorance, because none had ever seen the elephant. One would think that because the medical and pharmaceutical industries have grown so large that there would be less sick people in the world. But the opposite is actually true. There are more sick people than at any other time in the history, not just in actual numbers, but as a percentage of the population. It simply points out to an ineffective medical system that is focused on illness, that promotes profit-driven, expensive, invasive, and potentially dangerous medical procedures, drugs, or treatments, rather than simple, natural, inexpensive, effective treatments or therapies that have no side effects. There is a Chinese proverb which says, the superior doctor prevents illness. The mediocre doctor attends to impending sickness. The inferior doctors actually treats the illness. The information of this channel will encourage you to be your own healthcare provider, not to be your own doctor, but take responsibility for the choices you make daily and how they can affect your life. Holistic doctors and natural health practitioners are teaching us the fastest way to restore wellness is to quit putting into the body the things that have caused the physical problem to develop in the first place. The key is to strengthen our immune system. Nutrition, water, exercise, and rest in the right balanced amounts are crucial to optimum health and maintaining a strong immune system. Let us not give up or resign ourselves to premature aging, health problems, and death too soon. All of us want vitality and youthful vigor. It is up to you, the conscious individual, to make your own health decision. It is never too late to begin your journey towards wellness and well-being. I am not a physician and do not make any health claims. However, I can be responsive and informative to your needs. Collectively, through awareness, education, and knowledge, we can make a difference in our health and longevity. See you soon. Until then, stay healthy.